Today we will talk about Kamorta-class corvettes, and we'll understand, is Kamorta-class underarm? Many people think that Kamorta-class is underarm, because it is a 33,000-ton ship, and it does not carry any anti-air or anti-ship, or anti-surface weapons. Whereas Saar-class corvette is a 1,900-ton ship, and carries anti-air, anti-submarine, anti-ship, and anti-surface weapons. Well, Kamorta-class is a dedicated anti-submarine warfare corvette, neither a guided missile nor multi-role corvette. More precisely, Kamorta-class is a long-range, long-endurance, dedicated anti-submarine warfare corvette. Definitely, Kamorta-class does not need any anti-ship or anti-surface missiles. It needs more space to accommodate the crew for the long-range mission in the high sea. Both the Israeli Navy and Indian Navy have different mission requirements. Israeli Navy operates in its coastal water, whereas the Indian Navy is a blue water navy and operates in deep waters of open oceans. As I mentioned, Kamorta-class is a long-range, long-endurance ASW corvette. This means it requires sufficient fuel, food, and other spare parts to operate for a long time. If anything goes wrong with the Saar-class corvette or onboard helicopter, they can call for help from mainland Israel. But, if anything goes wrong with the Kamorta-class corvette or onboard helicopter, the onboard crew has to repair it on their own. In simple language, as Kamorta-class operates in the deep ocean, it is very difficult and costly to maintain logistics from mainland India. So they need everything on board to handle any situation. Whereas Saar-class corvette protects the Israel coastal water, maintaining logistics from mainland Israel won't be a problem. If you look at only the number, Kamorta-class is 60% bigger than Saar-class. But the question is it really 60% bigger than Saar-class? The answer is no. Kamorta-class measures 109 meters in length and 13.7 meters in beam. Whereas Saar-class measures 90 meters in length and 13.2 meters in beam. Kamorta-class is just 19 meters longer than Saar-class. Displacement means the weight of a ship. Technically, displacement does not define how big a ship is. If you use more strong metals in construction, then definitely ship will have more weight or displacement as compared to a ship of the same dimensions. To shrink a Saar-class corvette, it may require 1 to 2 torpedo hits. But to shrink a Kamorta-class corvette, it may require 3 to 4 torpedo hits or perhaps more. Now let's talk about the Kamorta-class corvette air defense system. Currently, it is equipped with 2 AK-630M close-in weapon systems. Initially, the plan was to equip with Barak 1 SAM system. Later, it was decided that it will be equipped with indigenously developed VLSR SAM. VLSR SAM is currently in the under development stage. That's why there is no onboard surface-to-air missile in Kamorta-class. You may have one question: what will happen if a Kamorta-class corvette faces an enemy frigate or destroyer? Well, come to basics, Kamorta-class is a corvette, and a corvette never operates alone. Corvette is always escorted by a frigate or destroyer. If a corvette is operating near the coastline, then escort doesn't need. If the enemy ship is dictated, then the enemy ship can be neutralized by a coastal battery or air-launched missile. That's it for today. See you in the next video.